Welcome back. It's Sports Tonight. We're reaching you live from Channels TV Sports Center in Lagos, Nigeria. And I want you to be part of the show. Yes, you can talk to us on Twitter, Channels _ Sports, Facebook, Channels Life in Sports. We are taking a look at club and country football. Ezekiel Hentz is a professional footballer. He plays for Videoton FC in Hungary. And he's been taking a look at the Super Eagles team. It's the World Cup here, remember? And I also like you to talk to us as regards that Super Eagles team as we count down to June the 14th. Yes, that's when the World Cup will kick off in June. Nigeria has been drawn in Group D and they will play Argentina. Once again, yes, there's Argentina, there's Iceland, and there's Croatia, Group D. Let's take a look. When the draw was made and Nigeria was drawn in Group D, did you it's an easy group? Or you said,
Actually, I saw the group and I was like, it's really tough. Ooh. Very tough because Croatia, Nigeria could get past Argentina. I'm not so scared of Argentina, but, you know,
you're
Croatia,
not scared of Argentina?
No, I'm not so scared of Argentina.
Current Argentina?
Yeah, I mean, Messi is a fantastic player. You got the likes of Dybala, Higuain, but
Aguero.
Yeah, but I think Nigeria has the fighting spirit. I think they could try to beat Argentina with that. But, you know, Croatia, they're very relentless. You know this because this part of Europe, they have really strong mentality and they go 90 minutes. They don't stop. You know, they fight. I think Nigeria is a fighting team, and maybe they could use that fight to beat Argentina if, you know, the other way around, the qualities don't work. So you could use this fight to kind of beat Argentina. And if you saw the friendly game, the Argentines, I think they have some players who are really temperamental, you know. So I think they could, if they see Nigeria posing a problem to them, they could lose their head easily and try to do something stupid, maybe get a red card in the game, because, you know, it's going to be a game of pride then, because Nigeria beat them already, and they're going to come back and like, okay, we're going to show them now this is a real competition. We have to beat them and show them and let them know their place.
This is the first angle I'm getting from this analysis, and it's beginning to make some sense. But Henty, Argentina, Nigeria has never beaten Argentina at the World
Cup. Exactly, and that's the point. And when Nigeria beat Argentina in the friendly game, and, you know, the internet got crazy and there were a lot of posts on Nigeria beat Argentina, of course they got angry because, you know, it brought down their pride. And in the World Cup, they'd want to come out with everything and try to beat Nigeria. And when they see Nigeria posing a problem that maybe after the first half, no goal, or maybe Nigeria scores, I think two, three players, that they're going to lose their head. But, you know, the Croatians are really calm and they fight. They are fighters, you know. They are really smart players and, you know, they are strong. You know, they're also very, very physical. So I think Croatia also is the toughest team Nigeria faced in that group.
Wow. You didn't talk about Iceland. Are they pushovers?
No, they're not pushovers. But, you know, I don't think, I mean, I'm not trying to see Iceland as inferior, but I believe in the Super Eagles, and I believe in what qualities there is in the team. So I think it's a game that Nigeria needs to take this 3 points. I mean, this should be like 90% sure 3 points for us, because, you know, you can't compare Iceland with Croatia or Argentina. So I think Nigeria should use this opportunity. I mean, because if we get 3 points from Iceland, they could fight for 1 point each from Croatia and Argentina, and that, you know, brings us straight to the knockout stage. So
yeah, and then you're saying it with so much calm and confidence, particularly the Argentina part. And so Nigerians will be like, he's making some sense with this, no tension. So let's just wait for the World Cup to come, Group D, and let's see. According to Hentz's formula, Argentina will come with a lot of pressure on their back because they lost to Nigeria in the friendly game, and then pressure, and then they might just get a red card and the Super Eagles just fly over them. It's football, anything can happen. Yeah. Let's go back to your club career. Videoton in Hungary, we're having a break now, should get back in February. Any plans of leaving soon, and where do you intend to go to?
Well, you know, I've always been moving, stuff, but yeah, I think, you know, I wouldn't want to say if there's any plans to move, but
this is what we always get. These players will not tell you they want to move, and they just hear that they've moved. Okay, where would you like to play your next football? You've been moving.
No, it's actually going to be Europe. It's going to be in Europe.
England, Spain?
No, England, no, not yet, you know, because I didn't make any appearance in the national team, so I can play for England.
True,
it's the load there. So Spain, Germany, Turkey, you never know. But they've been clubs.
Who's been talking to your agent? What club has been talking to your agent? But if you just tell me, we're having a conversation.
Yeah, no, but you know that's confidential now because you know you can't because you know in the club has a policy, mm-hmm. and in the club you cannot put these voices out because then the fans are gonna go crazy. It's gonna be totally. You can't say this because of the fans. If the fans come and you know because. One thing about interviews and internet, the messages fly so fast.
And they just think that you're
yeah, exactly.
Okay.
So,
I get you. But we'll be monitoring just in case we see. Oh, we asked him and he
didn't
say
anything.
How was it like at AC Milan?
Well, it was a good experience. Not so really, really. It was tough, actually.
Because I'm just wondering how you get off from the academy in Nigeria straight up to AC Milan. What sort of qualities did you show?
Yeah, I mean, the AC Milan scout came to Nigeria, and I showed the qualities that kept me moving, and they took me direct, and they paid about €150,000. So, but then it was not so easy. It was really tough because I had a quite bad agent, so. Then it was Italian, so it didn't care much for me, and you know it just left me on my own. I really had a tough time there, but I mean in life it's like that. You never expect anything easy. You have to keep working for everything, and in those difficult times they just make you stronger. So, but it was good because I played myself hard there, and I was ready to face all the challenges and football is adventurous.
So who took the €153,000? Was it the agents?
No, it was
academy?
No, the flying spot, the academy.
Oh, flying spot. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So.
How about agents and player, the relationship? How is it? Are there more of rogue agents out there?
No, football now is kind of really mafia business. It's agency. It's having an agent. It's not really necessary. My current agent now is Ayo Makinwa. And he was playing football when I called him because we have a really good relationship. And then I called him. I said, don't you think you should stop playing football and come to be my agent? Because at that point, I was doing really, really good in Slovenia. Mm. And a lot of agents, top agents, were coming. And I said I didn't need agent anymore because it's all about trust. Because agent talks to the club, not the player. And the player never knows what the agent goes to say. So if you don't have that trust, and the agent always work for themselves as well. You know, they want to get high commission and stuff. So you see many deals they flop, and you don't know why, but you know because the people at the backstage making decisions, and the players don't know nothing. So I think it's not really necessary to have an agent, just have someone you trust, because now FIFA, you don't need to go to any school to become an agent. You could get the license if you want to become one. So I think getting someone you trust, someone that would say exactly what you want, that's the best agent you could get. So
that's right. Oh, Ezekiel Hensi, I wish we could go on and on, but I must say thank you so much for stopping by. All the best with your club career. And then someday, if you have a chance to play for the country, take it.
Yeah, why not? I mean, I'm Nigerian, and of course, if I get a chance, I'd take it. And I'd try to give my best.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much, Ezekiel Hensi. So that's it. Ezekiel Hensi, professional footballer, plays for Videoton FC in the Hungarian Super League. And he's been talking to us about his club career and, of course, the Super Eagles of Nigeria. Let's go on this timeout. When we come back, Cosmos, Chukwu Emeka, and a longtime guest. We haven't had him here for quite some time. He'll be joining us later. We'll talk some more sports. Don't go anywhere. Stay.